I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
My campaign is called Reclaim Your Power. So that's, you know, sort of what that's about. It's just taking your life back and, you know, fighting for what's yours. And it's for yourself, for your kids. And, I wanted to give that back. So I do a lot of work at the shelter where I was, and I'm now an active advocate for women against abuse. And I, you know, travel around with them. Our most recent trip was to Harrisburg to advocate for just our programs there with the primary election coming up. We wanted to make sure we sustain our budget and that we can, to make sure we can keep our programs running.
I'm smiling because you're doing something amazing. You're really helping lives, you're inspiring people. But then I think, what do you do for a living?
This is it.
You beat up people.
I know, right?
Go ahead.
Please. Well, I know, I just find that I've thought about that before. Like, it's kind of, you know, but what we do, you know, some people view fighting as like something like almost barbaric or violent. And, you know, fighting is a form of those things, but if you're doing it for like the greater good, you know, then, you know, it's, to me, I view it as something positive. It's just, it comes with the sport, just like football. Like, football can be violent, you can get injured. It's, you know, but it doesn't mean you're being malicious. You know, we're not mean people. We're actually quite loving and nice, so.
How did the women in the shelter respond in the end of a class, after you inspire, after you talk to them? What did they tell you?
I'll try to get through this one without crying.
No. Why, so they cried?
I've had a few. We've had some really great moments, and it was one in particular. This was maybe a few weeks ago. You know, just doing our usual thing, and like the turnover rate there is so high, so sometimes we, you know, we don't get the same group every week. There's a lot of new faces that we get. So this woman in particular, she was new. And she, you could just tell she was still in that like state of shock. Like, she definitely had gone through something pretty traumatic. And, you know, we just try to stay positive. I don't really try to pry, or, you know, I never ask questions. It's just like, hey, we're here to work. Like, let's have some fun. And we keep it very light. And so, you know, I was holding pads for her. And she just started breaking down and saying, I know it's coming. she was, you know, kept saying, she was saying it out loud, which was, to me, she was affirming what she was saying by, like, saying it. And she kept saying, I'm not strong anymore, I can't do this. And at that point, I was just like, you know, I was like ready to fight her. I'm like, no, like, this is why we're here. We're here to fight. I was like, you know, we're gonna push, we're here to work, like, you know. And, you know, we just, you know, that's why we're here. We're here to, like, you know, push, make ourselves better and to get through it. And I said, you know, you're strong and you're here. You're still here. You survived what you went through, and, you know, and we're going to push. And she pushed all the way through, and there wasn't like a dry eye in the room. And at that moment, I thought to myself, like, man, this is exactly why, you know, we're here, like, why I'm doing this. And so, that just kind of got rid of all the self-doubt I had about my program. Is this working? Is it not? But there's definitely, the more, each week we like progress a little more, like we see more stories like hers where it's like, I'm not strong, and they are strong because they push through and they get through it. And they're like a different person after each session. It's like the smiles, it's just, you know, that after training glow that we get. So, it was pretty amazing.
You've went through it. You've obviously, you're a star now. You're getting famous. You're knocking people out. What advice do you have for any woman, any girl who's going through an abusive relationship? You've been through it, so what would you tell her?
I would just say, you know, it's never easy. But the hardest part is, I find, is first you have to accept it for what it is, in order to start your path of like forgiveness and moving forward. You have to like accept what it is, which is really hard because no one wants to accept that they're in a position where they don't feel like they have control. And I find that once you go through that acceptance phase and you start realizing like, this is my life. I'm in control of my life, and I'm big on forgiveness, and not necessarily forgiving and forgetting. Like, always, you know, remember, and like remember like where you were, so that you know you don't ever want to go back there. And you know, forgiving also to just let go of all the bitterness and resentment, because that's at the end of the day what really controls us, like in those situations, and not being able to push through and move forward, just to get to a better life and a better place, like spiritually, mentally. And so yeah, I would say like acceptance, you know, forgiveness, and
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.